I realized that it was a hugely contradictive situation that I was in, where I'm charging agents. I'm telling them, hey, it's not about the money, it's about relationships. But I'm like, pay me, even though it's about relationships. So it's very contradictive. When I went free, that was part of the issue was, and realized, like, when I went to free, I had 200 agents paying me a total of about $10,000 a month coming in, and I just cut that off. And part of the thought process for me was, it was hard for me to sleep at night for many reasons. One was, okay, I've got content here that is hidden from the public that people are paying for, but it got leaked out into the public. Now the people that are paying are reaching out to me saying, what the hell? Right? It's like I have to lock up content and not tell people certain things. I felt like in public, for the public, I was saying one thing and then saying, well, I was saying half a sentence and then, oh, okay, if you want to hear the rest of the sentence, you got to go pay and then I'll tell you the rest of the sentence. It felt horrible that I couldn't just let everything out. And that was part of that decision, was the fact that I wanted to just be completely transparent with everything and not worry about who's paying, who's not paying. Can I tell this person that? Can I tell that person this? That was a big part of it. On top of the fact that, I realized that it was a hugely contradictive situation that I was in, where I'm charging agents. I'm telling them, hey, it's not about the money, it's about relationships. But I'm like, pay me. Even though it's about relationships. So it's very contradictive, and it ate at me, to the point where I was like, I'm done with this, because when I look at the page, let's just clarify, there's a lot of really great paid coaches out there that really know their stuff and are great business organizers and prospectors and people in general, and I know a lot of them that I have mad respect for, but there's so many out there, and when you look at how they close you on their coaching program, it's the same strategies that they're teaching you to close your real estate clients with. It's like it goes hand in hand. They're using the same tactics on you as they're going to teach you to use on your prospects. And so when you're talking to a paid coach or one of their salespeople, and you feel like you're getting sold here, well, that's how you're going to start making your clients feel if you use their coach. People, like, they don't understand the power of human capital. They look at bottom line, tax returns, profit loss, earnings per share. They don't take into account how much the actual brand is worth, how much the human capital and resources that are at your fingertips based on your community that you build, and how incredibly valuable, monetarily speaking, that is. It's massive. It's massively more valuable than money itself, honestly. And for the free coaching, it was like I was looking at the data and I was seeing, okay, 300 people would sign up for our webinar, 100 would show up, and like one or two would sign up. And look, I'll take that one on the chin that maybe I didn't deliver the right way to just make people close. But honestly, that's not what I was in the business to do. I was like a wannabe webinar closer, and so I was really bad at it. But at the same time, look at the metrics. 300 people wanted help. 100 really wanted help. They showed up, but one or two actually decided to move forward and learn more about what I had to offer. I look at that scenario and I say, wait a minute. Why can I not try to help all 300 of these people? How can I help all 300, not just the 100 that showed up, not just the two that signed up? How do I create a scenario where all 300 get the value, and not only that, but now love me because of the value that I brought them. When I go to speak, I ask the audience, and of course, it's audience of Ricky fans and people that have been following me for a long time, and I say, hey, how many of you in this room would, if given the opportunity, do business with me? And every single person raises their hand, and I say, how many people have I charged a dime to for anything concerning coaching, information, etc.? No one. And so you think about the fact that everyone in that room said, I'll do business. I would love to do business with you if I have the opportunity to do business with you. But yet I've never charged them a dime for anything. And so if real estate agents can understand what I did there, right, and create the same scenario in their local market, how can you create a scenario where everyone is dying to do business with you, buying and selling properties? You know, however, you know, all you did was bring them value. You didn't charge them. Like, there's been people over the years that said, you should charge $1 a month for your weekly email that you send to your clients. Like, your client should, you know, pay you $1 a month or $5 a month or something like that. People will come at me with that. And I'm like, are you kidding me? That would kill my entire business. That would just crush everything that I'm. So here I am sacrificing money back into. That's an investment. I see that as an investment back into the industry, right?
That was a class move, by the way. I remember that YouTube video.
And
I remember watching it. I'm like, only Ricky Caruth. Ricky Caruth could lose $100,000 and turn it into like such an inspiring thing.
These events that I'm doing, free to agents. There were two of the seven events. I had zero sponsors, paid $5,000 or $10,000 out of my pocket, flew up to Charleston and Salt Lake. Those were the two I had zero sponsors for. Paid for the whole thing, venue, the whole nine yards, videoing, all of it. My travel expenses, paid for it all to have agents come into a room and let me see what I can do to help them and share my story and answer questions and stuff, right? So like for me, that human capital is worth so much more than the $5,000 or $10,000 that I didn't really lose. I invested. It's an investment. If I'm at a party, I'm not trying to, like, you know, there's been so many times, like, a friend of mine or my mom or something, we're like at a party, Christmas party, or somewhere out in public or networking event, and you know, somebody will say something about, you know, to somebody about, oh, I'm thinking about buying or selling something, and I'll hear Ricky across the room, and I'm like, oh shit, you know, please tell me they're not telling them I'm a real estate agent and I could help them do their deal and all this stuff, you know, because I'm introverted. And so what you got to understand is that, like, this is your job. Your job, what you signed up for, is to help people. This whole job, dude, the whole real estate career for an agent, is the whole premise of it is to talk to people you don't know, right? To help them buy or sell real estate, right? That's the entire, that's it. That's your job. And so you're telling me the one thing that this career is built on, you're scared to do, and you signed up and spent money for a class and did everything you could do to get set up and spent all this money to get to the point, and then now you don't want to do what you signed up to do? It's mind-blowing, bro. It's just mind-blowing. And I understand the nervousness of possibly making calls for the first time, and I'm completely empathetic to that part. What I'm not empathetic towards is not doing it and allowing that nervousness or lack of understanding or, you know, assuming what the outcome could be or whatever it is, stop you from accomplishing your goal, guys. You've got to have your eyes on the target, and you've got to go hit that thing. And if you know, for me, it was always like, am I gonna go home tonight and look at my family in the eyes, right, and say, I gave it all I had to provide the best life for you, knowing in the back of my mind I'm lying because I didn't make calls because I was a little uncomfortable? It's just super selfish, you know? And what it is it's people are unwillingness to grow as humans. You've got to stretch. If you want to do anything, you've got to stretch and you got to take risks.